Hi, I'm Sandy Graffius, your county controller. And somewhere along the line, I lost my sidekick. I think she's at home with a bad cold or something like that, so you just get me. And I have two folks with me tonight who are part of an organization called Mentors for Berks Youth. How was that? How was that?
Very good.
Yes. See, I had a cheat sheet here.
Yes.
A couple weeks ago, the Chamber of Commerce has a group of women, and it's called Women to Women. And I made an appeal at that time to any of the nonprofits in the audience to come to me, to come on to BCTV, because there are organizations in Reading that people do not know about. And I think it's time to let the best-kept secrets out. So I have with me Christine Sinclair. Did I do it right?
Yes.
Sinclair. That sounds so classy. And she's the executive director, and Dale Wilkins.
That is correct.
Did I do it?
Yes.
And he is the big chair of the board.
Yes, ma'am.
Chair of the board. Is that COB, chair of board?
We'll take it.
Cobb.
Yep.
And we have something called Mentoring for Berks Youth. Now, I know nothing about it, which is the way I want it, because that's the only way I can ask you guys what I need to know. First of all, is this organization for you a volunteer or you paid staff?
I'm volunteer. We're all volunteers within the organization.
So any money that you raise turns around and goes back into the organization?
Correct.
How am I doing?
Very good. Yes.
Okay.
That's exactly how it works.
Now, when you go to mentor youth in Berks County, how big is your board?
We have about 7 board members right now.
Okay.
We are always looking for new board members to be able to get new ideas and additional assistance with some of the tasks that we need to do.
When you try to do this part-time, does this mean that your nights and weekends are taken up by Mentors for Berks Youth?
Absolutely. But I love it. I love it. So I'm happy to do it.
And are your nights and weekends taken up by Mentors for Berks Youth?
Very much so, but I love it because, you know, we get to contribute to the community.
Oh, that was nice. That was really nice. I like that. I'm going to put that on a pillow and stitch it.
There you go.
Now, first of all, back up and tell me where you find the young people that need mentoring.
Okay, most of our students right now are nominated through the Reading School District.
Okay.
Most of the time is in the 8th grade, where we do an appeal to the teachers that we say, we explain what our program is and how we work with the youth by providing the one-to-one mentoring relationship with a dedicated adult in the community. So the teachers then nominate students that they identify as showing strong academic potential, but also recognize that they may not have all the resources that they need to help them to go on to be successful.
The support at home, and you try to provide the support that they need to encourage them to study, to encourage them to go to different activities. How am I doing?
Yeah, absolutely. That's absolutely it. And also to try and make a plan, what it is that they want to do after high school, whether it's a...
If you're doing 8th graders, wow. When you make a commitment to be a mentor, if you're mentoring an 8th grader, I assume you would appreciate that they would go right through the student to 12th. Is that correct?
Yes.
So you're not asking them to do 5 weeks and then bow out.
Correct.
No.
We do ask for a one-year commitment from a mentor, but what we find is once they start developing a relationship with that student, they want to continue through the 4 years of high school.
I see.
And that's really what we find works best, is the longevity of the relationship with being mentored with somebody through their high school years.
How long has this been going on?
Mentors for Berks Youth was established, actually, we celebrated our 30th anniversary.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
And I don't know about it. Oh, my gosh, I feel so sheltered.
Oh, no. Tom McMahon was our founder.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Really?
Really.
Isn't he a special person?
Sure is. And he's still involved.
Now, how did they get you into this? I was going to say sucked in, but I thought that sounds negative.
The previous executive director was a friend of another friend of mine who said that, you know, that they think that I would be really good for the position because I like serving the community. You know, I run a store locally, and, you know, I just enjoy having kids, you know, work around the store and stuff like that, just being a positive influence. And I interviewed with that previous executive director. And
for the board.
Correct, to be
okay.
On the board. And fortunately, I was selected to be on.
And then how long did it take them to encourage you to be the president.
Encourage? Oh, that's a good one.
I like that word.
Yeah, that was very good. I was just a board member at large, and then we started. We try to divvy up certain responsibilities within the board, so I took on activities.
Hang on a minute. Mm-hmm. When you say you divvy up if you're a volunteer and you're not working 40 hours a week trying to get this all put together, mm-hmm. does that then move to your board members the responsibility to get some of the stuff done?
Yes. We consider it a working board.
Okay. Yeah. So of your 7 board members, how do you have the stuff split up?
Well, we try to take
because you said you had activities. What does
correct.
That mean?
I run the activities. We try to make a plan for the year, mm-hmm. And then we try to plan out a year's activities, at least one nice group activity per month that the mentor and the protege can get together and spend some quality time with each other.
Well, hang on a minute. When you say the mentor and the mentee, is that
correct.
What you call the kids?
The protege.
And the protege.
Yes.
Whoa, that's a neat one. Wow. The activities that you're planning, are these group activities or are these a list of things that you give to the mentor and say, here's what we'd like you to do in a one-to-one?
That's really loose. I mean, what we do is we get together as a board and we try to network through the community by, I might know somebody at Reading Phillies. You know, could you help us out, you know, setting up a group activity?
Okay.
That we could get a nice group of tickets together so the mentor and the protege can get together and we could have a Phillies night or something like that.
How many kids are we talking about each year?
Right now we're serving about 25 students.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm. And we have a number of students that still need to be matched with mentors. So that's our biggest need.
I was going to say, I'll bet you that is the biggest problem, mm-hmm. isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Getting people to commit to mentor the kids.
Mm-hmm. But it really doesn't take a whole lot of time. As Dale was talking about the activities that we put on, what we do is we host at least one activity a month for both the mentor and the protege to be able to engage in. They're not mandatory that they have to come to them, but it's just an opportunity for them to get out and learn something new. As Dale said, we did some things. We did Reading Phillies this month in February. We're going to be going to a Reading Royals game as a group. Mm-hmm. In the month of March, we have an etiquette dinner scheduled.
What does that mean?
What it is there's actually an organization in Lancaster that's going to come and teach both the mentors and the protégés etiquette with eating and
setting up the right silverware and then working
absolutely.
Your way in from the outside.
Exactly, to know what fork to use.
Yep, and salad fork, dinner fork. Yeah.
And right. Where are you going to have your dinner?
We're actually going to have it at the Reading Inn, or the Inn at Reading, rather.
Huh.
And also, what
are you having to eat?
I think chicken or beef. I don't know. Come on
really
along.
I'm always
we'd love to have you.
I'm always interested in food.
That's right.
Well,
did you notice how my eyes lit
right.
up when we start the Reading Royals? I love the team, but you know, that's not like food.
Food, yeah.
This is Berks County.
Right.
and actually, too, at this dinner, what they do is they teach the students on how to interact with people when they're going for their college interviews, making eye contact, how to do a proper handshake.
How'd you hear about that program?
Well, the organization, it's been something that they've been doing regularly, I think every other year,
yes.
Hosting an etiquette dinner, and I researched a little bit and I found this particular organization in Lancaster.
That comes in and does this?
That they'll come mm-hmm. in and they'll do it.
Now, how are you going to pay for that?
With that, we do have a couple fundraisers each year. Our biggest fundraiser is we have an annual auction and dinner, which is normally held in October. So we get some funding for that, which does help to fund the activities.
When you have the auction and the dinner, notice my eyes.
I know.
Dinner
again. It's so good.
October.
That's really good. Right?
Dinner in October.
Dinner in October. Etiquette soon.
Boy, Dale, you're right in my way, buddy. Where do you get your prizes? I can't believe. Do you have other staff that volunteers beside you, or is it you and the 7 board members?
The 7 board members, we also do, our mentors often will assist with that in getting different donations to create the baskets and the other items for the auction.
You must have people that are so dedicated to what you're doing.
We really do.
That mm-hmm. they want to commit a whole lot of thought and time and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. How often are your board meetings?
Our board meetings are once a month, but we keep in regular contact through emails and I don't want to say really phone calls, everything's so social media nowadays.
Yep.
So
yep.
You know, everything yep. is just email or text and the information just goes right out.
So mm-hmm. you're doing eighth grade and you're getting your kids from the teacher recommendations.
Okay.
And you're getting your mentors from where?
Just out in the community. A lot of people really want to help students because they see that there's a big need, especially in the city of Reading. So they do want to help. So when I get out and I talk to people and all of the board members and other people who have actually been acting as mentors, that's how I'm getting them with their...
If somebody wants to mentor, is there some kind of a phone number that they can call? Or is there a web address? Or what do you have? What do you have for them to contact you?
Okay, so our website is m4by.org, and we also have our phone number, which is 484-273-2081.
Is that on an answering machine during the day because you're working?
Yes, it does go to a message if nobody's available, but when someone is available, we answer it as quickly as we can, and we do get back to people as soon as we can.
Do you have an age limit on what age they have to be a mentor? I'm sure you don't want somebody that's 15.
Right, not 15, but what they do recommend in terms of the age difference, at least somebody 3 years older. But what I find is usually it's somebody age 21 or older to be able to mentor. But if I can just back up a little bit about mentoring,
okay.
It really doesn't take a whole lot of time. What we say is it's about 4 hours a month, and that can really make the difference in the life of a student. It's keeping in contact with them weekly, maybe just a little quick text or a phone call or an email, and then just one visit once a month. It could be when we do our activities, participating in that, or going out to a cupcake store. We have a lot of great cupcake places around here, a cup of coffee, something like that. So it really doesn't take any more than about 4 hours a month.
I think a lot of it, too, has to do with the bond that is set up between the student and the mentor.
Mm-hmm.
Because depending on how involved you get in that young person's life, and I don't want to say child, because at eighth grade they're no longer children.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I think once you get involved in that young person's life and you get to know them, they become an extension of you.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
They sure do.
Many of our mentors have, told us how they have lifelong connections now mm-hmm. with their students, that
really?
They're visiting, they're going to their weddings, they're visiting them as they're having children, and they've become part of their life.
When you have a mentor set up and you have your dinner in October, do you charge to get in for the dinner? Is that how you make your money?
Yes, we do.
And then you also collect these gifts and you have an auction, is that correct?
Yes. Yes.
Do you then have a speaker? Do you have the young kids talking? How do you fill the hours beside eating for your dinner?
Mm-hmm. Well, every year at our dinner and auction, we do nominate a champion for youth. This past year, it was Representative Mark Rossi,
mm-hmm.
Who he told a great story, and he was able to engage the audience and express the importance of what we do as being mentors. We also had our...
One was Judy Schwenk. I was there that year.
Oh, yes.
Okay, that's right.
Yeah,
that was the year before I joined. That was about 6 years ago.
She and I support each other. No matter what we do, we show up.
Yeah,
and she
wonderful.
Still supports
wonderful.
Us, so that's a great, great help.
She's great.
She pulls... I don't know how she gets everything done. I don't think she sleeps to begin with. And I think she eats 2 bites at every meal because she does at least 3 fundraising dinners a night.
Well,
no, I'm fine. Okay, let's see if we can do anything here on this laptop because I want to see what you have here.
Okay, well, what I'll do is I'll just jump ahead. We've covered a lot of these things.
Okay.
What I'll do is go back on that mentor
screening and tell me what that is.
Okay, in order to be a mentor, obviously, safety of the students is the most important to us. So in order to be a mentor, we do go through a screening process. And what that includes is an application. So if somebody is interested in being a mentor, they would contact us through the m4by.org or a phone call. I would send them an application for them to complete. And on that, we do ask for references. We would contact at least 3 personal references. We also
make sure. And you do contact your references.
Yes, we do.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of time you put that down and they'll, because people call me and they'll say, can I use your name for a reference? I'll say, sure. I never hear
anything. You never get a call?
Yeah.
And I think, what a waste of time. Mm-hmm. Why would you bother to ask for references if you're not going to use them?
Well, yes. If they put you down for us, you would get a phone call.
Okay, good. I'm glad.
We also do the child abuse clearance check, Pennsylvania State Police check. If you haven't lived in the area for at least 10 years, we also are required to do an FBI check. Driver's license and insurance verification. We do an interview with myself and a member of the board. And we also have a training for the mentor to help them understand what mentoring is about.
How much time does that take?
That's about 4 hours.
Okay.
And I try to schedule
all at one time?
All at one time, yes.
Okay.
So I either try and schedule it on a Saturday morning, or we do sometimes split it over two evenings when we need to, but we do try and accommodate what the mentor's schedule
is. And at that point, you try to tell them a little bit about the organization, and you try to tell them a little bit about the youngster that they're going to mentor.
Correct.
Okay, mm-hmm. We're going to have to talk faster. We have 5 minutes left.
Okay. I just had a couple, I'm not sure if these would show or not, but there's just a couple photographs. Here's some. We do an annual trip. Do you want to
talk about that? We did a trip to the Baltimore Aquarium in Fort McHenry down in the Baltimore area last year.
How about that? That was one of your activities.
That is correct. Mm-hmm. Okay. That was our largest activity, and a lot of our youth don't get a chance to get outside.
I believe
that. You know, their backyard.
So I believe that.
Being able to get them on a real nice bus and take a nice ride and see some real different things.
I bet you they were just awed.
They loved it.
They
loved it.
They were just awed. Do you have anything else there?
Yeah. This was our whole group. Again, that was the one at Baltimore Aquarium. This year, we're fortunate to have a Live United grant, and we're going to be going to either Washington, D.C. or Gettysburg. Yep. We're still working out the details on that.
Oh, wow.
Which is wonderful.
And that's going to be one of your monthly activities. Is that your dinner?
This is one of our dinners, yes. This is the etiquette dinner where everyone gets a wonderful meal and learns how to use all those utensils. This was a recognition dinner that we had for our mentors and our protégés.
Okay.
Each year we do bowling, something just fun, because a lot of it is just growing the relationship with the mentor and the student.
But for those of you that got a pencil and paper, the telephone number is 484-273-2081. I'll say that one more time before we go off the air. If you have any interest at all in being a mentor.
This is just a couple photographs from a 3D printing workshop that we did. Because a lot of it, too, is exposing the students or our protégés
to
additional things that they may need in the workforce and to continue to explore things. So this was a 3D printing workshop that we had in the city. They have the Langdon Launch Box, and there's a 3D printing workshop down there that we were allowed to use, which really gave the students, you know, a technical skill that they may have not otherwise been able to experience. Here's one of our mentor and protege pairs. This young lady, she graduated this past spring, and she's now enrolled in college, so they were able to build a wonderful relationship.
That's terrific. Telephone number, 484-273-2081.
Here's a gentleman and his protege. This was another activity that we try and give back to the community when we can. So there's a group that clears a trail along the Appalachian Trail.
Huh.
So this mentor and his protege went out and got to do a great hike and also were able to clean up the trail.
Huh.
And it's just a beautiful picture there.
Yeah, that was nice.
That is terrific. What didn't I ask you? Because we have like 120 seconds left. This is called speed talking.
Speed
isn't
talking,
it?
Yes. I'd love to talk to anybody who's at least remotely interested in mentoring. We will be having a training coming up in March.
Okay.
And what that is even if you don't think you're ready to mentor, you can come and learn about it. And, you know, we'd love to be able to talk to you because there's students that can
help. Did you want to say anything? Because we really didn't give you much chance to talk.
No, I just want to say
you, but you're eye candy.
Oh, okay. All right. No problem. Just wanted to say it's a great time. It's very educational. And like I said, I'm all about community. So anything that we can do to help our youth and enhance this community, I'm all for it.
It's called Mentoring for Berks Youth. And you always have to have these acronyms. So it's like a capital M and then a four, Oh, look at that. And then BY is Berks Youth, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Telephone number, 484-273-2081. And my guest was Christine Sinclair and Dale Wilkins. And you were just delightful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This is called speed talking. And the only nice thing is that tonight I was actually behaved enough that I didn't ask you another question before you finished answering the one I had asked you. Every now and then I have a tendency to do that. I cannot tell a lie. I must admit that.
Well, thank you very much for having us.
Next week in County Connection, I have no idea who it is. It's going to be either Commissioner Linebach or Commissioner Barnhart because we're rotating. And then Tammy from our Aglian Center is taking over the fourth week. And I'm going to continue to feature people from Women to Women that have these different programs that are doing things in the community that nobody knows about. Mm-hmm. So anybody that's interested in either being a board member or interested in being a mentor, please give these people a call. Thank you so much. It was my pleasure having you. Good night.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.